It's now been 10 days since a lone gunman opened fire on moviegoers in Aurora, Colorado. The airwaves have been dominated by soul-searching. Most of the pundits have concluded that the main cause of this calamity is the dark, strange behavior of the gunman. Talking about anything else, they say, is silly. The New York Times' usually extremely wise columnist, David Brooks, explains that this is a problem of psychology, not sociology. At one level, this makes sense, of course, as the proximate cause, but really, it's questionable analysis. Think about this. Are there more lonely people in America compared with other countries? Are there, say, fewer depressed people in Asia and Europe? So why do they all have so much less gun violence than we do? The United States stands out from the rest of the world not because it has more nutcases. I think we can assume that those people are sprinkled throughout every society equally, but because it has more guns. Look at this map. It shows the average number of firearms per 100 people. Most of the world is shaded light green. Those are the countries where there are between 0 and 10 guns per 100 citizens. In dark brown, you have countries with more than 70 guns per 100 people. The U.S. is the only country in that category. In fact, the last global small arms survey showed there are 88 guns for every 100 Americans. Yemen is second at 54. Serbia and Iraq are among the other top countries in the top 10. We have 5% of the world's population and 50% of the guns. The sheer number of guns isn't an isolated statistic. The data shows we compare badly on fatalities, too. The U.S. has 3 gun homicides per 100,000 people. That's 4 times as many as Switzerland, 10 times as many as India, 20 times as many as Australia and England. Whatever you think of gun rights and gun control, the numbers don't flatter America. I saw an interesting graph in The Atlantic magazine. On a spectrum from yellow to red, red being the worst, it shows the number of gun-related deaths by state. Now, if you add one more piece of data, gun control restrictions, you see that the states with at least one firearm law, such as the assault weapons ban or trigger locks, tend to be the states shaded in lighter colors, meaning fewer gun-related deaths. Conclusion? Well, there are lots of factors involved, but there is at least a correlation between tighter laws and fewer gun-related deaths. I've shown you data comparing countries and comparing states. Now look at the U.S. over time. Americans tend to think that the U.S. is getting more violent. In a recent Gallup survey, 68% said there is more crime in the U.S. than there was a year ago. Well, here's what I found surprising. The U.S. is actually getting safer. In the decade since the year 2000, violent crime rates fell by 20%, aggravated assault by 22%, motor vehicle theft by 42%, murder by all weapons by 13%. But guns are the exception. Gun homicide rates haven't improved at all. They were at roughly the same levels in 2009 as they were in 2000. Meanwhile, serious but non-fatal gun injuries caused during assault have actually increased in the last decade by 20%, as gun laws have gotten looser and getting weapons has become easier. We are the world's most heavily armed civilian population. One out of every 3 Americans knows someone who has been shot. Look, everyone is entitled to his or her own opinion, but not to his or her own facts. Saying that this is all a matter of psychology is a recipe for doing nothing. We cannot change the tortured psychology of madmen like James Holmes. What we can do is change our gun laws.